Hello everyone, we're going to continue with 7.3 thin lenses. So what we have here is a biconvex lens with a refractive index of 1.6. The biconvex lens has two radii, one is 30 centimeters and the other one is 40 centimeters. So I'm going to sketch the biconvex lens like this. One surface is R1 and the other surface is R2. Now I have to determine the sign for the R's. In order for us to know whether the sign is positive or negative, there's a technique I like to call it as sukebuncit. Here is how it works. Let's say this ray of light comes from the left. We can see that this is buncit, right? Hence the R1 is positive 30 centimeters. But as it moves further to R2, the ray is now touching the Kuros surface. Hence R2 is negative 40 centimeters. But madam, how do you decide 30 centimeters as R1 and not 40 centimeters? I don't. It depends on the question. And since this question doesn't specify where the ray comes from, you can choose. And if you choose 40 centimeters as R1, you still end up with the same answer. As long as your sign notation is correct. Let me erase this. Again, ray comes from the left, hitting on R1, and it is sukebuncit. So R1 is positive 40 centimeters. And when the ray hits R2, it is negative 30 centimeters. So the medium is air, so I'm going to put 1.0 as the refractive index. Now let's find the focal length. We are going to use the lens maker's equation for this one. 1 over f equals to the refractive index of the material over the refractive index of the medium, minus 1, times 1 over R1 minus 1 over R2. From this point, it is quite straightforward. You just have to do the substitution and your final answer is 28.57 centimeters. Question B. If the lens is immersed in water, is there any change in the focal length and which way? Based on lens maker's equation, focal length is directly proportional to the refractive index of the medium. And as we know, the refractive index of water is much higher than the refractive index of air. Hence, the focal length will also increase. Question C. Now let's find the focal length when the lens is in the water. Again, we're going to use the lens maker's equation. The rest are the same except for the end medium. We're going to change it to 1.33, which is the refractive index of the water. And our new focal length is 84.46 centimeters. So mathematically, we have proven that the focal length of the lens, even though the material is the same, but because it is immersed in water, the focal length will increase.